Welcome to another Friday Focus video. Today, making a card that is included in the Simon Says Stamp Summer Release Blog Hop. So I'm going to be using a stamp set that's brand new to Simon Says Stamp, and it's one that I designed, so I'm really excited to use it. You guys have already seen it on a previous Color Wednesday, but I wanted to show it in a different way. So I started out by cutting and scoring some Basil Marshmallow cardstock, and now I'm using this little border stamp from Mama Elephant. This is from the Basic Border stamp set, and I wanted to make sure that it was completely straight on the block, so I butted it up against the edge of a ruler. This is a trick that I learned from Jennifer McGuire, which I think she learned from Sherry Carroll. I'm not sure where the idea originated. I just really love it, and it's really cool. So I started out with Stampin' Up! Starfruit, Summer Starfruit ink, and I wanted to have my grid mat showing on this first one so I could get the bottom bar or bottom border on there straight. But now I'm going to clean up the mat and then put some scratch paper behind it. And now I can just use that first stamped border as a reference to stamp a whole bunch of other colors. So next I used Hero Arts Orange Soda, and then I went to Hero Arts Ruby. And I'm going to go to Colorbox Chalk Ink in Wisteria. And then I'm going to go to Stampin' Up! Pool Party. I love this blue. It's so pretty. So I'll stamp that in Pool Party. And then the last color I'm stamping is from Stampin' Up!, and it's the color Wild Wasabi. So after I had all of those colors stamped, I wanted to make sure it was completely dry because I'm going to be embossing over the top of this, and any areas that have any moisture left over will attract that embossing powder and it won't be able to come off. So I'm just testing it. I just put that Inka Dinka Do embossing magic powder bag, and then I added some embossing powder and everything wasn't quite not sticking. So I did it one more time, added more of the powder, and that seemed to be the trick. So I'm using the stamp set called Pillow Talk, and I'm going to show you how to stamp the cat and then the pillow and make it look like the cat is laying on top of the pillow. So first I'm going to get this on here and get the positioning just right. This is how it's going to be overlapping. And so I'm just taking note that the cat kind of stamps about midway through the blue bar of ink. So I'm going to come in with Versamark ink on my stamp, and I'll just go ahead and stamp that cat right there. I love using the Fisker stamp press for this because I can really use my fingertips to precisely press down on the stamp image. So I sprinkled on some white embossing powder and then used a heat tool to melt that embossing powder. Now we're going to do some masking. So I stamped the cat in black ink on some Eclipse masking paper and then cut that out really carefully. Before I go ahead and start stamping, I'm going to put that powder bag on there one more time. And then I'll peel the backing off the mask and apply it directly over the top of the cat that's already embossed. This is going to make it so that when I stamp the pillow, it's going to preserve that area of the interior of the cat so that it looks like the cat is laying on top of the pillow. So now I'm stamping the pillow in Versamark ink just over top, and then peeled that mask off, and now I'm adding embossing powder, and it preserved that area in the center of the cat, so now it looks like the cat is laying on the pillow. So I decided to add some embossed polka dots on the top of this above the colored stamping, and so I use the Cuddlebug Swiss Dots folder, and then you'll notice that that top clear plate ends right above the green bar. So I use that cutting plate as a way to make sure only the area above the green bar was embossed. If you're unsure exactly how I did that, I'll link to another video up here in the top corner where I show a little bit more clearly. So then I used one of the Talk Bubbles dies from Simon Says Stamp, and I cut out some white cardstock. This die actually coordinates with the Cloud stamp in the Pillow Talk stamp set. So I just used a little bit of adhesive to adhere that down, and then I inked up that Cloud stamp from the Pillow Talk stamp set with some VersaFine Black Onyx ink, stamped that on there. And I'm going to be doing some embossing on this piece as well. So I'm doing the same process where I heat set it, make sure it's completely dry, tested it out with the powder bag, and testing it to make sure it doesn't stick. And it does still really, really stick a lot. So I actually dried it and added more powder two or three more times before I went on to stamping this sentiment. This sentiment is stamped in Versamark ink, And I'm just sprinkling on some white embossing powder, and the embossing powder is going to stick to all the areas where there was ink, the new ink, the Versamark ink. Heat set that till it melts, and then I'm wiping off any of the powder that's still sticking around, any of that embossing magic powder. So now I just adhered that down to the front of the car with a little bit of foam adhesive. And then I have this little baggie of pre-die cut red hearts, just picking out a little red heart. And then I cut a foam square down to a really, really thin little strip and adhered that heart down onto the card. And if you've been watching my videos for a while, you know what I did next. I added some Christmas red stickles onto that heart and also some black dashed lines above and below the stamping. And that is the card for today. Hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to head over to my blog and go on the blog copy. You have a chance to win a goodie bag from Simon Says Stamp. So head over there. There's links in the top corner of the screen. And I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.